Sometimes we imagine autocratic leaders sitting on a throne in judgment on their citizens, offering their thumbs up or thumbs down. Life or death on a whim. It is a caricature, of course, but this is a cartoon. It may not be life or death, but leaders make boundary decisions all the time. In or out, needed or not needed in a meeting or on the project team. Covered or not covered in the terms of reference, or the contract, or the brief, or the speech. And who is making the decision? These are all boundary choices. By choosing what and who are included or excluded, we draw lines around issues, shape the ways people see them, and therefore what we choose to do about them. Thinking about boundaries and what is included or excluded is at the core of systems thinking. Leaders who are aware of complex systems make conscious choices about boundaries. They realize they are trying to manage or influence a system, and that decisions on what is in or out can have big effects. Imagine we're stuck in traffic in the city. We're going to be late for an important meeting, or perhaps we will miss our flight. It's so frustrating. We could get out and walk faster. Why can't the government get anything done? Why don't they extend the freeway to right where we are right now? That would be just magic. Let's imagine we wave the big infrastructure wand and now we're on the magic freeway. It's great. Except there's more traffic than I expected. And it's a pity about the neighbourhood. There used to be some great local parks and cafes over there until this highway was bulldozed through. A magic transport solution for some people can mean other communities just miss out, and the magic doesn't always last. Transport issues are good examples of boundary choices. How the issue gets framed, which problems are in and which ones are out, where the money comes from and where it can be spent, all these shape the analysis of the problem and the options considered. So too do choices about the people who get consulted and the ones who make the decisions. Sometimes people draw a boundary around a transport issue and call it an engineering problem. How to build a freeway, a bridge, a tunnel, or a rail network as effectively and cheaply as possible. Those who live in the affected communities might draw a different boundary. They might call it a problem of how to connect up communities without destroying them. Can we get the traffic off our streets and not lose our community? City leaders might draw a bigger boundary and try to consider the well-being of the whole city. How to create a thriving economy with efficient transport and healthy, vibrant neighbourhoods. Great cities are exciting. They have the benefits of lots of people and opportunities being close by, and yet they are easy and safe. People can get about easily and quickly, but the streets are not clogged with traffic. Making transport and connections work in our most loved and livable cities is an art form. Over time, city leaders have built transport networks that move people about easily. And communities have had the foresight to invest in efficient public transport and places to ride and walk and to protect what they most value. A lot of different systems have had to be connected up, and that has almost always happened with heated arguments. Easy, livable cities are often not easy to make. Many people have to hold a bigger view of the different challenges. Each time we draw a bigger boundary, we make the challenge more complex. We probably need to involve more people, and we also change the ways of thinking about the issue and likely solutions. The transport and city examples are similar to what leaders and teams are doing all the time as they work in systems. They help to change thinking and feelings by drawing lines around issues, setting boundaries, and trying things out. Each boundary choice is also a system choice. Do we treat this as a big system or as a smaller subsystem? Who is on the team or can come to the meeting? Who is not invited? Are we including all the people who agree so we can take united action quickly? Or are we bringing in all the folk who might argue back so we can involve more people in taking the issue forward together? What is included in the brief or terms of reference or contract? What is excluded? What do we write down and what do we leave out? Systems thinkers see that when they make these choices, they are choosing whether to take a larger view of the system or a more focused one. They see that each choice has advantages and disadvantages, and also it can have consequences that we cannot see in advance. They also get that they may need to change focus as they go, to zoom in or to take a wider angle. It is much more than thumbs up or thumbs down. Our thumbs and fingers are too busy for that. We need them to be adjusting the focus again and again to hold different perspectives.